In this video, we'll talk about the what and the why of chaos engineering. Then we'll look at the AWS fault injection simulator, which is a tool that you can use to perform chaos engineering. And then we'll take a look at a demo. So what is chaos engineering? Chaos engineering is when you introduce failures or faults into an application. You then observe to see what happens, and then you fix based on what you've actually observed. Why would you need to perform chaos engineering? Because you want to be ready. You want to be prepared for when things actually go wrong. We know that failures are inevitable. And we always hear that the moment chooses you, not the other way around. So when the moment does choose you, you want to make sure that you're ready. Chaos engineering is an experiment like a scientific experiment that you would perform. So because of this, it has phases. So what phases are actually involved in chaos engineering? The very first phase is the steady state. With the steady state phase, you define what things look like in a normal condition. So you say this is how your system looks like when everything is going according to plan. Once you've defined your steady state, then you would define your hypothesis. With a hypothesis, you say, what could go wrong? What if my cache breaks? What if the load balancer breaks? These are the questions that you start asking yourself. Once you've defined your hypothesis, you then start the experiment. Then you run it. And when you run an experiment, you start small. You start with a small portion of the application. You iterate from what you've then learned. Once you run it, you verify the outcome, and then you fix. When you fix, you perform improvements on your application based on what you've learned. The AWS Fault Injection Simulator is a managed tool or a managed service on AWS that you use to inject faults onto your applications. You then learn from these and you iterate and perform improvements on your applications based on what you've learned. So what are the use cases of AWS FIS? Think about game day simulations. So think about a seasonal spike that you've experienced in the past, a weakness that has taken place in your application previously. You could simulate that. Also, you would want to integrate this as part of your delivery pipeline. And this is because your deployments to production are already automated, so you'd want to integrate into that pipeline. Another use case you could think of is to run a CPU stress on an instance. And when we look at the demo, we will see what that looks like. So I already have an EC2 instance that we're going to use for this experiment. Let's pay close attention to some of its attributes. Look at the VPC. It's going to be important for later on. And let's look at the tag, because it's going to be important for later on as well. You can create your FIS experiment either on the AWS console or the AWS CLI. Now, let's take a look at how you create it on the console and then start your experiment from there. Now let's go into the AWS Fault Injection Simulator to create our experiment template. We're going to give our template a description. I'm just giving mine EC2 Stop Experiment 1. You can call it whatever you want to give as a name and as a description. My name I've given same, and then you're going to add an action. With an action, you're saying what you actually want done in this experiment. And also, you're going to give your action any name that you want to give, and same goes for your description. And now we're talking about action types. I did say earlier on that you can perform these experiments against a couple of AWS services, and these are all that you can do, but I've selected the EC2 action type. And you can either stop, terminate, or reboot an instance, but I'm selecting to stop an EC2 instance. The next option that you have is start after. And here you can say that you want this action to happen after another one, but I'm leaving this blank. And then I define another optional that I want to start this instance after a certain amount of time. And I've said after a minute, I want it to start. Remember to save your action. And now I'm gonna go and define my targets. Remember earlier we looked at tags, and now I've selected a resource tag as my target method. And we paid close attention to that name of that tag, and now we're defining it here. We're defining a key name, which we saw previously, and the value is the My EC2 FIS experiment that we looked at previously. So all instances with that tag will be targeted for this experiment. I've chosen all. You could have chosen a count or a percentage. I'm leaving everything else blank. There already is an existing IAM role for this experiment. And this role has to have access to perform the experiment against these targets. Everything else I'm going to leave as blank. I'm not sending logs to my Amazon S3 bucket, nor am I defining stop conditions for this one. The tag we've already seen, and now we create our experiment template. You're going to be prompted to enter the word create. Enter that and then press create experiment template. And now you have your experiment template. And from here, you could start the experiment. I'm choosing to start it from the experiment template console. And I'm pressing start experiment. And then again, there's a prompt and I enter start and I start my experiment. And now my experiment is running. While it's running, let's go and see what happens to our EC2 instance. We see it has already gone into a stop state. It's pending, meaning it's gonna come up again because we've said after a minute, bring it up, and it's running again. Now let's look at the experiment. We see that it has completed. Now, let's look at how you can create your experiment using the AWS CLI, paying very close attention to the stop condition. Now that's my name of my template that I'm going to be creating via the CLI. You can see the name of the resource. We looked at it previously. It's in a running state, and that's the VPC it's in. Now stop conditions are via the CloudWatch alarm, so I've got that defined, and I run my create template command, and it now creates my template. And then now we're on the console, and we can see. Finally, let's start the experiment from the console. The main thing to note here is that although you created this template on the AWS CLI, you still come back to the console to start it. So let's start the experiment. So it is running. Now let's go back to the EC2 console to see what's happening to our instance. It is stopping. It has stopped. And now back onto the experiment. What is happening? It was running and it has now completed. Now back onto the EC2 console. It's pending because we did say after a minute, bring it up, and now it's running again. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed that, please give it a like and also consider subscribing to the channel. See you on the next video.